Hello. Sorry we were late, but we were just tuning.
Thank you. Today's Friday. Today's Friday. Friday's fish. Thursday's shepherd's pie. Wednesday's a roast beef. Tuesday's soup. Monday's washing day. Is everybody happy? You bet your life we are.
Hello, my darling.
Hello, my darlings, and welcome to Chipp Ahoy here on Smile Radio. You're listening to the show that turned it up to 11. That first track was My Name is Ruin from Gary Numan off of the Savage album. I think that's the best thing he has ever done, and it has to be listened to loud. And I was watching a programme, a retrospective of the old Grey Whistle Test, and he played this live when it came out in 2018, and I heard it again. I thought, right, I'm going to play that. And then the idea of a loud show came to mind. And I've asked for requests, got many, many requests, all of them tremendous. But I like the way people have thought outside the box, if that's the right phrase, and not necessarily what you would think of as loud songs, but just songs that work because they're played loudly. However, there are some. Welcome home there from Peters and Lee. Now, the next track, it's one of mine. You'll hear why. The whole recording of the album, the sound engineer complained that everything was turned up to the max. So, what better track to put on the show than I Heard Her Call My Name from the Velvet Underground.
Got my eyes wide open. It's since it was on Cripple Monday. I got my eyeballs on my knees. I was baby walking. I'd rap for hours with Mad Mary Williams. Said she never understood a word from me because I know that she cares about me. I couldn't call my name.
Of White Light, White Heat. Stories after the recording were saying that the band were trying to play as loud as they could and louder than anybody else in the band, and you can almost hear that throughout the song. I love that. A friend of mine back in the early 70s said he used to meditate to that. He'd put that track on repeat and meditate. I don't know, I suppose, yeah, you could switch off from the world listening to that. You might not be able to switch back on again, though. When I sent out requests for this show, the first one that came in was from Kieth Graham, and it was Nightwish and Noise. We have had this before. No problem with that at all. It's a great track.
Thank you.
from Nightwish there, requested by Kieth Graham, that well-known spelling mistake. The next track is Colourbox. I do play them occasionally. This is certainly one that benefits from being turned up.
The lusty decadent delights of Imperial Pompeii.
Notify ground crews.
There off of the album Colourbox and the track Just Give 'Em Whiskey. It's worth exploring that album. It is very good. There's a multi-CD box set of various bits and pieces they did. The album itself is the thing. Right, two tracks now from Gary Moxon. Before I forget, Gary, have a good holiday, mate, up in Scotland. He requested Deep Purple. And this is Live Highway Star. And then ZZ Top and it's Sharp Dressed Man. Now, I'm bound to get this wrong because it starts very slowly with bits and pieces, and I'm trying to talk over it and see if I can time it properly for when the singing and music properly starts. I think I've got it wrong.
Yeah. about as sharp as me.
Man there from ZZ Top, and before that Highway Star from Deep Purple, both requested by Gary Moxham. Now, the next track requested by Dave Cooper, he's a big fan of Deep Purple, so in a sense that first track was for you, mate, but he chose Heavy Metal Kids and She's No Angel.
She's a
No Angel there, Heavy Metal Kids, requested by Dave Cooper. He did question whether I'd play it or not because it might be a little too poppy. I don't think that matters. You'll see, you've heard already Colour Box and the like, and there are others later on in the show, Dave, so I think that was a really good choice. It's a long time since I heard that, which is no bad thing. Good to be reminded. Right, the next track, it's Lynyrd Skynyrd. It's Saturday Night Special, and it's requested by Mrs. Trellis of North Wales. Strangely, I heard this morning on Planet Rock. Saturday Night Special, Lynyrd Skynyrd.
One, two, one, two, three.
Two feet say, come on, breathe.
Saturday night special there from Lynyrd Skynyrd. Right, the world's worst record. Malcolm of Brentford, he messages in quite often, usually pointing out I've said something wrong. He requested or suggested this. This is Lou Reed, Metal Machine Music. When it came out, it was a double album, each side 17 minutes and 1 second long. Although side four had one of those grooves that keep repeating itself, so you could leave it on for as long as you could stand it. The cover looked like a proper rock and roll album, hard rock album, if you like. Lou Reed in leather and everything. And then when you played it, it was a shock. Unsurprisingly, I love it. I went to see Lou Reed performing it in Cambridge a few years ago and adored every second of it. It is one of those albums that you can put on headphones especially, loudly, and it just sounds magnificent. But I can understand why practically everybody in the else in the world thinks I'm wrong and thinks I'm mad. This is a 1 minute 33 second version off of a collection called Between Thought and Expression. They didn't put the whole track on, they just put this on. Have a listen. Don't bother telling me what you think, because I know. This is Metal Machine Music, Lou Reed. Was 1:32 according to Spotify. 1:32 of feedback. Lou Reed called it Metal Machine Music. As I said, I loved it. Malcolm, I can understand your choice, mate. Right, the next track. It's requested by Matt Kidd. Matt and Mrs. Kidd, Nicola, request quite often, make suggestions. And as he said, I've taken this literally. The track, I asked for loud songs. And this is Meatloaf, and it's Everything Louder Than Everything Else. It's nearly 8 minutes.
I know that I will never be politically correct. weeks of a respite and the early morning, just another waste of you. They say I'm wild and I'm reckless. I should be acting my age. I'm an impressionable child in a tumultuous world. And they say I'm at a difficult stage. But it seems to me that it's the military of all the crap they're gonna put on the page. Got a wasted youth is better by far than a wise and productive old age.
Louder than everything else there, as requested by Matt Kidd, certainly not requested by Kieth Graham. He's just sent me a message that he's just managed to tune in and he doesn't like meatloaf. Well, he said malt loaf. I know what you mean, mate. There's something over the top about meatloaf that I don't mind, whereas some of the over top bands like Queen just couldn't get. You've missed your track, Kieth, I'm afraid, but it was a good one anyway. But you've heard it before. Paul Ramsden sent a couple of requests in. His family lives abroad. He'd been abroad, came back, had to self-isolate for 14 days. He came out of that self-isolation earlier on this week. Late last week, beg your pardon, but he sent two requests. Second Black Sabbath, This is going to be Iron Man followed by New Rose from The Damned. Two great choices, mate.
Thank you. another day. I got a new rose, I got a good. Yes, I knew that I always would. I can't stop to mess around. This could happen to me. Oh, this is strange. Oh, why should it be? I don't deserve somebody this great.
Damned there, and New Rose. And of course, it has to be followed by another punk track. This was what came to mind.
We'll be right back.
Sex Pistols there, and Pretty Vacant off of Nevermind the Bollocks. Here's the Sex Pistols. Right, the next two tracks are from Jody Hayward. Jody is reliable. If you want some rocking songs, she'll give you a list as long as you want. These are two bands, or two artists, that are new to me. Royal Tusk and Scott Stapp. Royal Tusk, the first track they're playing is Freedom, and the second, It's Gone Too Soon by Scott Stapp. Thanks, Jody. I hope you enjoy them.
Until I reach
too soon there, Scott Stapp, requested by Jodie Haywood. Thank you very much, Jodie. I'll investigate both of those artists in the near future. Right, this is mine. Head Over Heels, J.D. McPherson. Over Heels there from J.D. McPherson off the album Let the Good Times Roll. I don't ever get fed up with that. I must listen to it four or five times a week. And yeah, it's one of those. Right, the next two tracks. Again, good, different choices. Nick Kidd shows both of these. The first is Placebo and Nancy Boy. And the second is Drowning Pool with Bodies. I'm sure you'll enjoy both.
Alcoholic, kind of lead, lose my clothes, lose my lube, cruising for a
Bodies There from Drowning Pool. Before that, Nancy Boy, Placebo. Both suggestions from Nick Kidd. Two great tracks that certainly fitted the loud brief for the show. I prepare the show in advance, make changes all the time. 1:10 this afternoon, I realised I hadn't put any David Bowie in. I have now. There, David Bowie off the Rise and Fall of Ziggy Stardust. Right, two tracks now for John Keyes. John isn't very well at the moment. I was going to say he fell off Ben Nevis. He fell on Ben Nevis. Quite a fall, but he's okay. He's got bruises and various other abrasions, but he seems to be on the mend. So get yourself well, John, and these two tracks that you suggested. The first is Blur and Song 2, and the second is Deeper Underground from Jamiroquai, the man with the hat. I'm told Song 2 was called that because it was 2 minutes and 2 seconds long and they didn't have a name for it. Whether that's true or not, I don't know. It seems to fit, doesn't it? I love both of these.
Woohoo! Woohoo! I've got from humans with guns. But now it's too late, there's no escape from what they have done. Come on!
Jamiroquai there, Deeper Underground. Now, you've been waiting again for a Lou Reed track. This is called Nowhere At All. It was a B-side, and it's too good to be a B-side, but apparently it was felt it didn't fit with the albums at the time. Completely disagree, but it is fantastic, and it's fantastica if it's loud. Nowhere At All, Lou Reed.
Just gone like it all now. Somebody's got to hear.
Nowhere at all there from Lou Reed, fulfilling the brief. Right, this next band came to me this morning. I'm a Brentford fan, and I know of various musicians and the like that are or pretend to be. This band, Keller Machine, came up on the fans' website and recommended by others, including Tom Robinson. Yes, that Tom Robinson. And I looked on their website and it said, the song that played at that party and everyone smiled, the songs must be played loud in capital letters. I thought, well, I've got to listen to this, haven't I? I did. I enjoyed it. Hopefully you will. This is Keller Machine and Keller Dome.
Girl meets boy, boy is girl. Real love in a neon world.
Keller Machine there and Keller Dome. Keller Machine, K-E-L-L-E-R. I'll be playing another track from them next week. Really enjoyed that. I hope you all did. Right, the next track. We've got all this way into the programme. 1 hour and 46 minutes without Led Zeppelin. Seems balmy, doesn't it? Rectifying it now. And we're going to follow it straight afterwards with Patti Smith, Ask the Angels, off of Radio Ethiopia.
Hey, hey, mama said the way you move gonna make you sweat, gonna make you groove.
We'll be right back.
There, Patti Smith off of Radio Ethiopia, and Black Dog from Led Zeppelin. There were many I could have chosen from both of those artists, and they were both my choices. I struggle to understand that nobody suggested Led Zeppelin. Anyway, maybe they're a bit passe these days. We have played nothing from pub rock early 70s, and I was going through which I could have chosen. And I chose this. This is Dr. Feelgood. She's a wind-up.
She got a fine-looking figure when she's walking down the street. She gives a quick see you later to all the guys she meets. I want to hear her moan when I want to get home. Action starts and then I got to go home.
She's a wind-up, wind-up. She's a wind-up, wind-up. She's a wind-up.
Feel Good there, She's a Wind Up, one of the many, many songs we've played throughout the show that benefit from being played loudly. we called the show that turned it up to 11, and I think that's right. We're going to finish with Alanis Morissette. She was on the telly a few months ago. I thought, oh, I must re-listen to Jagged Little Pill. Never did until last week. And then I heard this, and I thought, this would fit. So we're going to finish the show with You Ought to Know from Alanis Morissette. You've been listening to Chipp Ahoy here on Smile Radio. I hope you've enjoyed it. I have no doubt that you will think of songs and tracks and artists that I should have played. Get them to me. We'll do this again in about a month, I would have thought, as long as we can still do that sort of thing. I live in the Leeds area, and Leeds is one of those areas that's under threat of another lockdown of some sort. We'll have to see, though, won't we? So thank you very much for listening. As I say, I hope you've had a good time, and I'll see you next time. Ta-ra!
I want you to know that I'm happy for you. I wish nothing but the best for you both. I know the version of me. Is she perverted like me? Would she go down?